Hi, I'm Johnny Engineer Turmel, running for Prime Minister of Canada to save it from the nuclear radiation bombarding us from Japan. And I want to know, is the Fukushima plutonium that's been hitting Canada for the past 2 weeks responsible for all the rain? Is the radioactive plutonium seeding the clouds and pushing the rain down on us? Okay, this is the plumes of radioactivity approaching the North American continent, and you can see that Canada gets the brunt of it all. The main plume aims right at Canada. Now, they've had alerts down in California, San Francisco, about the radiation being 180 times higher than normal, but nothing in Canada. Now, why would that be? This is the printout from the Health Canada mobile radiation detector site. And you'll notice over here that the very last day was March 25th when they stopped giving out the radiation. Now, they said the reason was the frequency of data collection has been decreased due to the low levels of radiation detected. Of course, they want you to turn off your smoke detectors at home too because there have been low levels of fires. So that's a pretty stupid excuse to give, and it's now gone from that site. Besides, reducing the frequency of data collection to zero means turning it off. Now we can see here, this is just a little example of the kind of radiation that hit Canada a couple of weeks ago. But what's interesting is that there was an article on the net about the two different. You see the one on the right? That is the real radiation. And the one on the left is the picture that was issued to the public. And both of these are from the same day, same period, same server. So, yes, it looks like there is a cover-up to keep people in the dark, perhaps not to panic them. But between you and me, I would rather find out it's dangerous to get out of the radioactivity than send our children to play outside in the radioactive rain when we're told that kids have a 10 to 100 time greater susceptibility to cancers from radiation than adults do. So yeah, Harper's heroes have gone out and played in the rain, give up 10, 15 years of their life expectancy to keep the panic away from the Canadians. Well, the reason I'm asking is, they keep saying the radiation comes down in the rain. And that's how it gets on the grass and the cows eat it and it gets in the milk and they give it to the kids and then the kids get their cancers and die. So, but now they're not publishing the radiation in the milk no more. They decided not to do that anymore. Gee, I wonder why. My question is, and you got to give it some thought, is all that plutonium in the air causing all the rain that Canadians have had for the past couple of weeks? If you've noticed, it's been raining almost every day. This is maybe the third day in 2 weeks where there's been no rain. Now, we know that they seed clouds with different things to get the water to form around it and fall. Now, water doesn't weigh very much. You know, H2O, two hydrogens and one oxygen, doesn't weigh very much. You know, maybe 30, 34 units of... But uranium is 235. Plutonium, big pieces of metal at the atomic level, which means that probably it's pretty easy for the water to form around these plutonium grains, these plutonium seeds, and then come down. So my question is all the rain we've been experiencing a function of all the Japanese plutonium that's been hitting Canada for the past 2 weeks? Is that why it's been raining full time like I've never seen before? Because of all that heavy uranium and plutonium in the atmosphere around which the water droplets can form and fall? Good question, isn't it? So, is having radioactive plutonium in the air the cause for all the rain over the last couple of weeks? Think about that.